It's great for me to have an event here in Amsterdam.
Amsterdam to me is interesting because the entire city is below sea level, hence the canals is a very beautiful scenery.
It feels great to travel again. It's been a couple months and it's nice to have a free vacation.
Completing that with my first world tour, it's pretty special to me. In my home county, of course, it's perfect.
The come back to the live events, also with the live audiences supporting you. And yeah, it's gonna be even much more adrenalinic event.
I think it's great that Gran Turismo is being able to kind of blur the line a little bit of real racing and sim racing. Getting close to real racing is very difficult sometimes, but Gran Turismo makes it possible to, you know, get involved into that. And if you are competitive in the game, then maybe you can get a chance nowadays to get to real stuff. It will be possible to a lot more people to get, you know, into racing, so I think that's great.
Manufacturers taking to the grid, 35 laps of action, but only one can be crowned as the winner. It's lights out and we're racing here for the World Series Showdown for the Manufacturers Cup in Amsterdam at the Suzuka Circuit. Team BMW lead the charge over the timing line, but look at Porsche already trying to launch an attack on Team Subaru. Mercedes getting their elbows out seemingly into the first corner as well. They all managed to make it through turn one.
Subaru's glued to the back of the BMW, has a bit of a half move there.
Oh, and the BMW wide. They're wide, Subaru going through, Porsche going through, Nissan and also Honda taking the opportunity here.
As we go into the hairpin, Lamborghini at the inside contact. Oh, no, Honda round, are they round? They spin, half spin, they managed to keep the car in one piece.
Mazda into the box, they've gone for the intermediate tyres early as well. The rain is now starting to come in on the radar. Look at it, it's raining now very heavily at this part of the circuit. So, Porsche in, Toyota in, everybody else is on the dry tyres, they've got to come in. Oh, McLaren are off, it's really bad indeed. Team radio we just heard, straight off into the barrier on the outside of the final corner.
Subaru into the pits, so our race leader into the pits, onto the hard compound of tyre. They think now is the time to swap over, and I'm inclined to agree.
It's side by side down the start finish straight. The inside line is what Porsche has, and second position is what they have as well. Porsche then to the outside. Serrano trying for the long way around the outside of the hairpin for the race lead in the Manufacturers' Cup, and he goes through. What a drive, what an overtake from Jose Serrano and Team Porsche. But they come around the final corner. Porsche have delivered here in the Manufacturers' Cup World Series Showdown. They win in Suzuka in spectacular style.
Bueno, pues la verdad que estoy muy contento. Es la primera victoria en un World Tour que hago. Lástima que no sea con Ángel aquí, pero bueno, desde aquí se lo dedicamos a él.
I like the new format for the Nationals Cup because the Nationals team is with together with your teammates, your friends. It's pretty cool for the spectacle, for the battles on the track. So let's see the result and see the race. I'm really excited to that.
Drivers are in their rigs, they're lined up and ready to go ahead of 30 laps of racing action. As we get ready then, the grand final for the World Series Showdown in the Nations Cup. It's lights out and we go racing then as France lead the field down towards the first corner here at Lago Maggiore for the first time.
Down here to the bottom, Team Spain goes to the inside of that soft compound tyre immediately up into the lead. That is super important there.
He's going to try and send it down the inside in towards the final series of corners in the right-hander. Italy holding firm on the outside there. A smattering of body contact, but Kobayashi goes through into the podium places at the end of the opening lap.
Yeah, again, looking for a move there. Big lunge there from Suzuki and Team Japan. And France have no idea what to do there. Apart from the position, tries to get back by again, but it blocked well. Up the inside goes Baptiste Brochoir for Team France, makes a move up to P4, but now, a little bit wide there, and slow on exit, and he loses both positions.
Braga sends it down the inside and through into fourth position.
A big round of applause there for Team Spain. It's been a great race for them so far. Can they hang on for eight more laps? Brazil go to the inside to get by. So Brazil are going to go up to third place. There you go, Brazil there. Team Brazil onto the podium. France through as well into P4. France is the slipstream, but here you see the tyre life. Team France really struggling. And as I say that, the rear tyres Team France going away and into the wall they go. An uncharacteristic mistake there from Kylian Drumont.
They have not put a foot wrong all evening. They come through in towards the final corner. It was Jose Serrano who won in the Manufacturers' Cup today. And as part of Team Spain in the Nations Cup, Spain wins here for the World Series Showdown in Amsterdam. What a performance by 16 seconds.
We are so, so happy for the victory today, especially because we did no mistakes, we performed very well. And this is the way we want to go on for Barcelona for the World Finals to try to repeat this result.
マニュファクチャーに関してはちょっと荒れたレースになっちゃって僕らも反省してます。もう少しうまい、レースの作り方があったかなと思っていて、ただ最終的にポルシェが逆大逆転で勝ったのはすごく良かったですね。ポルシェのドライバーたち、今回2人でしたけど、すごかったと思います。ネーションに関しては、ネーションズに関しては、すごくクリーンな、いいバトルがあちこちで見られて、で、結果的にやっぱりスペインはすごく速くて逃げ切りましたよね。ブラジル、イタリア、それからフランス、どれも速いチームだったんですけれども、やっぱり序盤でタイムを失って、最後はスペインに追いつけなかった。あとやっぱり日本が2位に入ったのもすごいと思いました。